welcome to Bacchus Health Beat, your source for health information and the latest health news. Today we have with us Dr. Setu Vora. He's a pulmonologist and he's also our physician director for performance improvement. So welcome, Dr. Vora.
Thank you, Sean, and thank you, Jeff. Appreciate the opportunity.
We're here to talk today about the flu season, which is really probably one of the worst flu seasons we've seen in quite some time. I mean, certainly, it's been really busy at Bacchus and at hospitals across the state and across the nation. We've had, I believe, 200 and some odd cases of confirmed flu so far this year compared to, I believe, 15 all last year. That's amazing. So I don't know what you can tell us about this year's flu season and how you put it into perspective. I mean, how, you know, is it a really bad flu season? Is it just a good old-fashioned flu season? I know compared to last year, anything would seem severe.
The unusual part starting off was how soon it started. New unusual aspect of this flu season is the early onset. It started out in late November.
Yeah.
And we're hoping that it's already peaked, but it could go on till March. So out of a typical 12-week flu season, we are in the fifth week right now. So we have a long way to go. The virus that is the main culprit in the flu this time is the so-called H3N2, and the vaccine is a perfect match. The problem is the virus H3N2 is typically responsible for severe disease. So we're seeing much more impact, so to speak.
Yeah, I know that we've had, I want to say, 28 people hospitalized due to the flu, ranging, and the people that are getting the flu. It's not like H1N1 where children were being hit real hard. From what I've
and
heard,
pregnant ladies as well.
Yeah, from what I've heard, it's across the whole spectrum, four months to 94 years old.
Yeah.
And it can be dangerous for people with underlying conditions.
So to put it in perspective, out of a 12-bed critical care unit, to have 5 patients there with influenza, that's a lot by any standards. So that kind of matches up what Boston is seeing, that last year they had 70 cases around this time and now they had 700. That's a tremendous logarithmic jump that led them to declare the public health emergency.
Yeah, that's amazing, and I know that Bacchus and the surrounding hospitals have been hit hard by flu and also a number of other diseases as well and conditions.
And that often leads to the question: did the vaccine fail? And it's really good to realize that the vaccine is a very good match for the H3N2. It may not cover the small minority of B virus, influenza B virus. But there are other viruses going around the same time, such as, we all know about the stomach flu, though the so-called, norovirus.
Yes, yeah.
The 24-hour, 48 hours of vomiting, diarrhea, people think it's the flu. It's a different virus altogether. This is the worst outbreak of whooping cough going on right now in the last 60 years. So you have a triple whammy, it's the perfect storm.
And there's other respiratory issues,
sure.
Pneumonia, and
the routine standard ones that we see with the cold season.
So is there any chance that since the flu season started early, it'll end early, or?
We would sure hope so. With the climate change, you don't know how the viruses cycles and reacts. 2009, we had a summer flu, right? With the swine H1N1 novel influenza. So we'll have to just wait and see. The typical season goes on almost till March, so we still have about 7 weeks to go.
Well, it looks like we do have a ways to go. So that being said, if somebody hasn't gotten a flu shot, would you recommend that they still do?
It's never too late. It takes about 2 weeks to build up the immune system, so you're still looking at 7 weeks of potential influenza activity. Just get it. It's available at Bacchus.
The Bacchus
centers,
health centers. Yes.
It's available at our offices as well. So
that's
just
great.
Call ahead, get it done.
Excellent. So what are some other, I know getting a flu shot is the best thing you can do to avoid getting the flu, but are there other things that can be done as well?
Yes, prepare, but don't panic. Start planning early. When the flu season is about to begin and vaccine is available, just get it early on time, so that you don't have to scramble at the last minute when the season really builds up. and you're looking at, you know, where to get it, always use the standard common sense technique that our moms and grandmoms and teachers taught us. Always cough in the sleeve or inside the shirt. Never use your hands in public. Always wash your hands with soap and water. If that's not available, carry a small alcohol sanitizer with you. When you go to shopping malls or at supermarkets, just use the hand wipes when you're using the shopping carts. A little bit of common sense will go a long way in prevention. If you are sick, if you do have fever, and you have a respiratory illness such as cough, you're sneezing, your shortness of breath, stay home. Don't be a hero. It's a perfectly good public health method to limit the spread by staying home, at least till you're fever-free for at least 24 hours.
So, Dr. Vohra, is there, I think people are, there's conflicting opinions on this as well. Is there any treatment for flu, for the symptoms of flu? I mean, does Tamiflu work? I mean, what?
Sure.
What is your opinion on that?
So Tamiflu is oseltamivir. It's the antiviral medication. There is another one called zanamivir as well. So there are two available right now. We generally keep that reserved for patients who have underlying severe conditions. Someone who has underlying asthma, severe emphysema, congestive heart failure, someone who has severe diabetes, they are at higher risk for getting complications.
Yes.
So in those patients especially, we start the treatment and start it early. Only then it helps cut down the duration of the illness and maybe reduce the severity of the disease.
Great.
If you're otherwise healthy and you have the flu, the best thing you can do is stay out of circulation, eat, drink, plenty of rest, you'll get better.
So another question I have, is it true that if you get a flu shot and you do still get the flu, can it limit the severity? Can the flu shot limit the severity of?
You got it right. So even if it's not 100% protection, typically the effectiveness of flu vaccine is about 60 to 70%, which is not bad if you think about it.
No.
Even if there's a flu that you get in spite of vaccine, the severity is lower. So it doesn't hurt to get it.
So I read, Dr. Vohra, yesterday I read in Massachusetts they've had 18 deaths from the flu. I think that sometimes people don't realize that the flu can be deadly.
Yeah, I mean, when you're familiar with something, there's complacency. If there was, you know, two or three cases of anthrax or Ebola, we would have chaos, right? But influenza, everybody knows about it. It happens every year, so we kind of get complacent. But to remember that influenza is the number one killer amongst all the infectious disease in the United States. 35,000 people die every year.
Wow. Well, Dr. Vohra, thank you very much for joining us today. And, you know, here's to hoping that we indeed do have an early end to the flu season. But if we don't, it seems like we're hopefully well prepared. And you've given some good information for the public to be well prepared as well.
Thank you very much for having me. Thank
Great.
You.